Hi, my name is Andrea. I work in an arts department, and in this video I'm going to explain how you convert from RGB color mode to Cmyk color mode. First of all, I'm going to explain a little bit about what the color modes are about and why you need to convert to Cmyk. And then I'm going to show you exactly how you convert to Cmyk in Photoshop. Then you're going to notice that the colors are going to shift and not look quite as flattering as when you first started. And finally, in Photoshop, I'm going to show you how to make the colors look better again and more rich so you're ready to send the image to a printer.
There are two different color models. One is RGB, the other is CMYK. RGB stands for red, green, and blue. CMYK stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key, or black. Most of your at-home inkjet printers are going to be in RGB color mode. If you take a picture with a digital camera or you pull an image from the internet, most likely that's going to be in RGB color mode. And of course your monitor is in RGB. However, if you send something to a commercial printer, you will be required to convert the image to CMYK. You convert your image to CMYK when you send it to a printing company because it's printing at a four-color press. This is a four-color Ryobi press, and each one of these sections of the machine print a different color. So you have to convert your images to CMYK because you're sending them to a four-color press. This is Mount St. Michael in France. I didn't take the picture, but I thought it was a beautiful screensaver here, and it's going to make a great example of what happens when you convert to CMYK. So I've opened up my image here in Photoshop, and let's just directly convert and see what happens. So if you go to Image, Mode, and then watch the colors here, the colors have gone flat. Some people procrastinate on converting to CMYK because if you go to your filter menu, after you've converted to CMYK, there's some stuff that's grayed out like artistic, brushstrokes, etc. So they want to work in RGB as long as they can and make modifications. So let's do that. We'll hold off on pulling the trigger and converting to CMYK. If you go to View and Proof Setup and you switch to working CMYK, if you look up at the top, you're still technically in RGB, but you can see what all your colors look like when you convert to CMYK there. That's one thing you can do. Photoshop also has another way to show how your colors are gonna shift. If you click on View and Gamut Warning, you're gonna see that the sky's gonna shift, these colors are gonna shift a lot. Even if you go in your color picker, you're gonna see that there's colors that you're just not supposed to pick because they're out of the color range of the CMYK gamut. So that's kind of the fancy features of Photoshop. But let's get down to brass tacks. How are we going to fix our image? So I pulled up our images side by side. On the left we have the RGB image. On the right we have the image that's converted to CMYK. If you take a look at the sky, you'll notice that there's more gray in it, and if the grass doesn't look right, there's not enough definition or darkness in the grass. So what we're gonna do right away is I'm gonna increase the saturation. So hopefully that's gonna help with some of the flatness of the image. So I'm gonna just do an adjustment layer, a few saturation, and we'll bump that up to, probably around, 28 looks good. We'll just do that. And then let's do another adjustment layer. And this time let's do selective color and try to work with each of the colors independently. The blues definitely are a problem. They're just not looking as bright as they should look. So I'm gonna increase the cyan to about right up here. It's looking better. And if we go to the blacks, I'm gonna back those off a little bit because I think there's just too much gray in the sky, and I'm gonna back that way down. And then I'm gonna go to the neutrals layer. I'm gonna increase the black just a little bit. That should help with our grass looking kinda bad. Helps a little bit. I mean, the grass still is not gonna be as perfect as it was in RGB, but that's gonna help give just a little bit more definition to our grass. And I don't think we're looking too bad. You can still work the image a little bit more, but I think the image is significantly better after we have worked with it a little bit in Photoshop.
Don't get frustrated when you're trying to work your image. Just think about RGB. RGB has such a wide range of colors, and when you convert to CMYK, there's not quite as many colors to choose from, so you're not going to get it exactly the same. However, if you just take a little time, work with the image, use adjustment layers, then that image is going to look so much better, and eventually you'll be ready to send it to the printing company.